hey, future respiratory therapist, hey, I'm going to do a couple of rapid fire type videos here with some things that I hope helps you prepare for your final exams. So what I got on the board here today is key radiological findings. And what we're talking about here are chest x-rays. And I want you to know that when you're taking a test and you see some of these key terms, that you already know what the answer is. Answer it, go to the next one, okay? Because these terms are very specific and they're very key to these disease processes for which we're talking about, okay? So we're going to go ahead and get started right here. We're going to start off with this first one, which I believe that everybody knows. If you're taking your test and you see that an example says you're looking at an x-ray and a patient presents with blunted costophrenic angles. Now, I put CA up there, but that stands for costophrenic angles. So blunted costophrenic angles, what disease process are we talking about? That's exactly right. We're talking about a pleural effusion. Every single time, no questions asked, blunted costophrenic angle is pleural effusions. If nothing else, it puts your mindset in the right disease process to know what you're dealing with. Now, the second one here is curly B lines. Now, curly B lines are associated with one disease process and one disease process only, and that is pulmonary edema, which often is tied back to congestive heart failure. Now, when you take your exams, this may be expressed as cardiogenic pulmonary edema. However it says it, you know you're talking about pulmonary edema, curly B lines, pulmonary edema. Blunted costophrenic angles, pleural effusion. Now, the next one on here is honeycomb. Now, when we're looking at an x-ray and you see and it describes the findings as a honeycomb appearance, then we're talking about interstitial lung diseases. Not always, but most of the time, this is going to take us to the disease process of pulmonary pulmonary fibrosis. Okay, so honeycomb, pulmonary fibrosis. Now, the next one you see here is ground glass appearance, and that one is simple. Everybody knows that one, right? Ground glass appearance is simply ARDS. You got to know that, okay? You see an example or a test question or information that says ground glass appearance, you're talking about ARDS, and you're going to put your mindset in the ARDS findings. Now, I'm going to follow this video up with other key findings, and then I'm going to follow it up with, again, with key findings associated with each of these disease processes. So maybe that'll help you classify and put these things in your mind when you're taking your board exams too, or your final exams. You have a reference to go back to say, okay, this is the key radiological finding, and I'm putting myself in this ballpark right here. Okay. So the next one you might see is where a x-ray describes that there's a loss of lung markings. They may use the words radiolucency or hyperlucency. And when you see that, they're saying there's an area on the chest x-ray that there's no lung markings. Well, what would cause something to be radiolucent and lose lung markings? And that brings us back to a pneumothorax. Now, my final one that I have written on the board here is this, and that's any time you're described on the chest x-ray that you see or you notice or there's a statement about an air fluid filled cavity, meaning you have a cavity that's filled partly with fluid and partly with air, then now we're talking about a lung abscess. Okay, so these are the key findings. Now, of course, there's other ones out there. Like if I was to talk about emphysema, for example, then I would use a variety of terms such as flattened diaphragm, okay, due to the chronic air trapping. I would probably say something about an increase in the intercostal spacing. I would say something else about the long, narrow heart appearance. Okay, and then I would talk about bilateral hyperlucency due to the air trapping. So the air trapping will cause bilateral hyperlucency. It will depress the diaphragms. It will cause the intercostal spacings to become greater. And the response to that is that the heart gets pulled down and twisted so that it looks more like a bicycle seat. Sometimes you may see that, or it may even just say elongated heart. And those would be things that you would tie back to your C-babes in times of air trapping. I hope this helps. Leave me your comments below. Let me know if there's a video that you want me to do that's not already here. And I'll get it done for you. So best of luck to you in this upcoming week. And at the end of the day, go be great.